my name is Oriel Speaker. Today we are learning about side saddles. Side saddles have been used for generations for both men and women and therapy. Side saddle has been shown in historical reenactments, and it's used in therapy for people who have bad knees, hips, or back. According to Owl's site on humanology and side saddles. According to Historic UK, side saddle, it was not traditional it's been dated clear back to 13 of not riding astride. It really became popular for riding side saddle in 1383 when Princess Anna of Belgium rode all the way across Europe to marry King Ralph and it was used to provide virginity. And it was from then on, it was frowned upon for women to ride astride from then on. So, the English side saddle, as we have here, was originated over in England, and you have your cinch or girth, depending on if you're talking about the English or Western style. There are also Spanish styles, which we don't have out here displayed at this time. So, on all side saddles, you have your horns or pommels, or is what these are called. When lifting a side saddle, you always want to grab the top horn or pommel, and you usually want to pick it up like this, because this one is normally not fully attached to the side saddle, and it will twist and come undone. And this long cinch here goes underneath, and it is a back cinch, like this cinch over here. And it is to keep the saddle from sliding and falling off. And the cinch is, or girth, depending on English or Western, is this, and it's the same on both English and Western. And it does the same purpose of keeping the saddle from sliding. And it just holds it to the horse. So, you have your whips, which is not for beating friends, family, or others. It is for lightly tapping the horse's side to get them to go forward. So, this is a traditional Western whip or prop, whatever you want to call it, to get the horse to move forward. It's longer to be able to get more maneuver out of the horse, to tap back further or up forward more, depending on the terrain you're riding on. The English whip or court is this. You slide it onto your hand this way, and it is literally just to tap the side of your horse to get them to go forward. You do nothing more with your English whip to get them to do anything. It is literally just to get them to go forward because normally you're not doing technical riding and stuff. So, you may be wondering how you are going to steer and stop when you get on. That is what the bridle is for. You have your reins to steer left and right, and your head, and it needs to fit the horse properly according to bit on the side saddles. And so there are multiple ways to mount side saddle. You have your traditional mounting block, which has been used to get on. So I'm gonna have my helper, Rachel, step up and on. So she's gonna put her hand on the top horn here, and she's gonna put her left foot in the stirrup, which is here. And then she's gonna step on, and she's gonna pivot, or swing over. And then you put your one leg over top of this horn here, and then your other one goes in your stirrup here, and then it will rest up against this horn here. So if anything goes wrong, you can clamp down with your both legs and hold yourself onto the horse. And then I'm gonna have her slide back down so you can see how she steps off by herself. That is how you get off with a mounting block. Now I'm gonna have her get on with the groom. So she's gonna put her hand up here. So put your hand up here. And then up. And then she sets the same way on. And she puts her foot in the stirrup. And then you still have your same traditional over and under. And then she will usually have her whip taken to this side by somebody. And then she holds it on the side where she doesn't have her leg. And then she will check to see what type of gear she can see, if it needs fixed, feel how comfortable the saddle is for herself, and see if it fits the horse okay. End to pivot around their front, or if you need to, you can reach it forward and have it pivot, have them pivot on their hind quarter, which is efficient for going around sharp trees and having to side pass and do that sort of thing. And then when she wants to go forward, she just lightly taps with her whip and her off leg at the same time. And then she can steer from there. As you can see how the saddle does not slip and slide, that is because you have the back cinch holding it on, and you don't have any issues with the slipping and sliding. And then when she's ready to dismount with her helper, or hand, or groom, or depending on what you want to call it, she'll ask her groom to come up to her, and then she'll usually past the groom who are wet. So she'll slide it up and over and then down. And the groom will usually set it down somewhere. So set it over here for now. And then she will, and you want to make sure that your horse is perfectly stopped and standing perfectly still before you dismount. Because otherwise you'll hurt yourself and the horse and most likely your groom to go along with it. So, my helpers Melanie and Rachel will demonstrate how to slide down with the groom. So she unhooks, make sure she's all the way unhooked off of everything. And that is how you dismount off of a side saddle. So, that is it for today. Thank you all for coming.
Yay!
Good job, Aurora.